Hello again, and welcome back to Plants and Lucia. My name is Lucia, and this right here is Maria Yatraki. This is because this plant is actually a cutting from a bigger mother plant that lives in Greece. And it was a very nice gift from Maria Yatraki. So that's why that's her name. Today, we're going to talk about the Tradescantia cilamontana. Okay, coming up! Whether you're coming back or this is your first time in this channel, thank you so much for being with me and watching this video. I am a plant beginner and I learn about houseplants every day. So this channel is just to share with you what I've learned with my plants. So if you want to learn how to take care of your houseplants, how to display them, or even how to connect with them, make sure to subscribe so we can see each other every week and talk about plants. But now, let's get to the video. The Tradescantia cilamontana is actually also commonly known as the white velvet, the white gossamer plant, or the cobweb spiderwort. She actually comes originally all the way from Mexico, even though this beautiful plant comes from Greece. And it comes from dry, warm areas in the region. In terms of how it grows, this plant does not exceed the 40 centimeters in height. And the leaves grow in a very interesting and geometrical way. They actually grow 180 degrees across from each other. So when you look at this plant from the top, it looks really beautiful. In terms of color, the leaves have an olive to gray-green color with silver-white hair around the leaf. And there is a natural reason for this woolly looking hair. Remember, this plant comes from a very dry and hot area. So the hair actually protects it against very strong sun rays and also the loss of water from the leaves, so it can stay hydrated. This plant will bloom between spring and summer depending on your location and the care that you give her. The flowers tend to have a magenta color and they usually have 3 petals. They're actually really pretty. So I hope that we can see some flowers from this plant this year. Okay, so now let's talk about how you can keep your plant happy and healthy at your house. In my experience, the Tradescantia cilamontana doesn't need so much humidity. I actually keep it really close with my other succulents, and she seems to be doing fine. I think this is because this plant comes from Mexico, from dry and warm areas. So a normal amount of humidity in your house should be fine for her. In terms of temperature, remember, this plant comes from warmer temperatures, so try to keep her in a room that is at least 18 degrees Celsius. When we talk about light, the Tradescantia in general is adaptable. However, they really love bright sunlight, so provide full or bright indirect sunlight. We actually have our plant with other succulents right in front of a south-facing window, so she gets lots of sunlight, and she seems to be happy there. Of course, this also depends on where you live and how much sunlight you get in the room. So make sure that you observe your plant and see if she's not getting too much sunlight or too little sunlight. If she's getting too much sunlight, you will see that the leaves are starting to burn. So you can prune these leaves and try to move your plant where she's not gonna get so much sunlight. But I can tell you, at least here in Berlin, this plant is actually doing very well in front of a south-facing window. In terms of potting mix, this plant really likes well-drained potting mix. Remember, this plant is closer to the succulent side of the spectrum, so you want to provide really good drainage so you don't overwater your plant. So, as you can see with ours, we have one part organic soil, one part perlite, and one part succulent potting mix. This is to provide a very good drainage for the plant, and it helps not to overwater it. In terms of water, I actually water my plant in a moderate way. So with this plant, I usually water every 1.5 weeks to 2 weeks. You want to make sure that you let the soil dry in between watering. So I always check the soil before I water. And the way that I check is with my finger. I put my finger inside the soil until the second knuckle, and once I feel that the soil is dry, then I water. For this plant, since it is closer to the succulent side of the spectrum, I usually water as I would water my other succulents. And it has worked really well because she gets the water that she needs, but she is not overwatered. In terms of fertilizer, it is recommended that you fertilize your plant during the growing season every 2 weeks. For this plant, I'm actually using a fertilizer that is special for succulents. This is the one that we got in Germany, and it is actually working really well. So if you're interested, I'll just put the link in the description below so you can try it out. Okay, my friends, these are some of the tips that I can share with you about the Tradescantia coelomontana. Do you have a white velvet at home? How do you take care of it? Make sure to comment below so we can all learn together. If you would like to be part of this community, you're always welcome. So make sure to subscribe so we can see each other every week and talk about plants. And as always, I will see you in the next video. Okay, bye! Or the cobweb spiderwort.